गुड मॉर्निंग किड्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक एंड दैट इज वर्ब एक्शन वर्ड्स. ओके एंड इट्स काइंड्स ऑफ वर्ब. ऑल राइट, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल क्वेश्चन इज वॉट इज अ वर्ब. अ वर्ब इज अ वर्ड विच सेज समथिंग अबाउट अ सब्जेक्ट. ओके सो वॉट इज अ वर्ब, दोज वर्ड्स विच से समथिंग अबाउट अ सब्जेक्ट आर वर्ब. ओके so let's see the examples there. John hit Tom. So this is our subject. What the subject is doing? He is hitting somebody. Okay, so in this sentence John is our subject, hit is our verb, and Tom is our object. All right, so what the verb is doing here? A verb, it is actually saying something about John, that which activity John is doing. All right, so John is actually hitting Tom. John hit Tom. Okay, next, the boys are playing football. So in this, the boys, this is subject, this is verb, and football is object. All right kids, so the boys, what the boys are doing? They are playing. What they are doing? Are playing. So in this sentence verb is are playing. What is the verb? Are playing. All right, now you will be asked here to tell the helping verb and main verb. All right, so in this sentence I will tell you what is the, actually the verb is the combination of helping verb and the main verb. Okay, whenever there will be any action, that will be the main verb. Okay, so and the words which will support the main verb, okay, that will be the helping verb. So in this sentence are is helping verb and playing is main verb. Okay, are is used to support the main verb, the action play. Okay, so are is used to support playing. That is why this is called the supporting verb, or we can say the helping verb, which is helping the main verb. All right kids, so what is verb? A word which says something about a subject. Okay, that is a verb. So doer of the action is subject, verb action word. Okay, so next, helping verb. Those verbs which help the main verb are helping verbs. Is, am, are, was, were, has, have, had, will, shall. Okay, these all work as helping verb in the sentence whenever there will be the main verb given. Action word will be given. Okay, now we will see next kinds of verb. All right, so first sentence we will say, see here, the man killed. What the man killed? It is not given. The man killed. Okay, so what? It is not given. Okay, so now if I'll say the man kills a snake. Okay, here object is not given. The man killed, that's all. No object is given. Okay, but in this sentence, so here this is subject, killed is verb. All right, object is not given. Okay, but next sentence we will see, the men, this is subject, killed, verb, a snake, this is object. What the man killed? Snake. Are you understanding? In first sentence object is not given, but in second sentence object is not given, object is given. All right, now let's see next, the hunter shot. What the hunter shot? That is not given. So hunter is doer of the action, so this is subject. What is the action? Shot. So this is verb. And what did the hunter shoot? It is not given. So it is, here we can say object is not given. Okay, so the sentence is incomplete. Next we will see, the hunter shot a tiger. So in this sentence the hunter is subject, shot, verb, a tiger, object. All right, now let's see third example, the boy pulled. What? That is not given. Again, the boy is our subject, pulled is our verb. Okay, object is not given. All right, if we will write the sentence like this, the boy, this is subject, pole, verb, the Bobs, object. Okay, so in this sentence, object is given. So kids, there are basically three examples given. All right, now we will understand about the kinds of verbs here. In these sentences, the verbs alone printed in color, okay, verb alone do not make complete sense. Okay, something must be added to each to complete the sense, right? So to complete the sense, something is added. All right, so second sentence of each we will see. Okay, first, second we will see. Okay, this, we need a snake. Okay, in second also, a hunter shot what? A tiger. Okay, the boy pulls, it was not given here, but it is given here. The boy pulls the box. So we are talking about these sentences. Okay, in these sentences, the verb alone do not make complete sense. Something must be added to each to complete the sense. So what did the man kill? A snake, right? A snake. What did the hunter shot? A tiger. What did the boy pull? The box. The word snake is called the object of the verb killed. The word tiger is called the object of verb shot. The word box is called the object of the verb pulled. Are you understanding? Now, what I just want to tell, a verb which requires an object after it to complete its sense. Okay, so I'm talking about these three sentences where we need an object to make the sentence complete. Okay, so here the verb is called transitive verb. Why? Because verb needed the object to be completed. That is why the verb is called here transitive verb. All right, again, a verb which requires an object after it to complete its sense is called a transitive verb. In your question paper, how you will get the question? Suppose this example will be given, the man killed, and you will be asked to tell the kind of verb. So if you will go through this video, then easily you can answer, right? So the man killed, it is not the transitive, right? The man killed a snake, yes, this is a transitive verb. So in this way you can answer. Now exercise we will see here. Underline the transitive verb. Okay, what we have to do with transitive verb? We have to underline and circle the object, and to object we have to circle it. Okay, so mother cooked dinner for all the guests. So mother cooked, what the mother cooked? So in this, what is the object? Dinner. Okay, what she cooked? This is verb, transitive verb. All right, she talked. So talk is what here? This is transitive verb, talk to her mother. So her mother is what? This is object. Driver must stop. So in this sentence, must stop is verb, helping verb and main verb. This is actually auxiliary and this is the main verb. Okay, must stop what? Their cars. So car, their cars in this sentence is object. The doctor asked the nurse. The doctor asked, so asked is what here? Verb. The nurse, object. Okay, now next we will see, read the sentences. Fire burns, the girl smiles, the sun shines, birds fly. So you can see, girls, girl smiles, fire burns, the sun shines, birds fly. You can see, fire is subject, burns is verb. The girl, subject, smiled is verb. The sun, subject, shines, verb. Birds, subject, fly, verb. You can see here, there is no object given, right? Object is not there in these sentences, okay? So in these sentences, the verbs by themselves make complete sense, and do not require objects after them to make complete sense. Okay, so these sentences do not require the object to be completed. That is why these sentences, these here, the verb is intransitive verb. In these sentences, the verb is intransitive because the verb is completed itself and it doesn't need any object to be completed. That is why the verb is called an intransitive verb. Now let's see the definition. A verb which does not require an object to complete its sense but makes good sense by itself, okay, is called an intransitive verb. Okay children, again, fire burns, that's all. We do not need any other things. We do not need the object here, okay, to complete its sense, okay, but it is actually giving some sense by itself. So here it is called, the verb here is called intransitive verb because verb doesn't need any object to be completed. Okay, next, read these sentences. A dog is an animal. The woodcutter seems tired. A thief always lives in fear. The woman became sad. Okay, so in this sentence, an animal, tired, fear, sad. Alright, why these are given in pink color? Now we will see here the next topic, next type. Okay, and that is the verb printed in color that I have underlined do not make complete sense by themselves. Something is added to each verb to complete the sense, but these verbs do not require objects after them, okay, to complete their sense. They require other words to complete the sense, okay. So the women became sad. So sad is not the object, it is the other word, okay. The thief always lives in fear, this is the other word, it is not the object. The woodpecker seems tired, this is also the other word. So beta, in those sentences where object is not needed, in place of that the other words are given. So there the verb is called, the verb is will be called incomplete predication. Okay, so this is the next thing. Such verbs which do not make complete sense but require some words or words after them for this purpose are called verbs of incomplete predication. Okay, so the word or phrase so added is called the complement. So word or phrase so added is called the complement. These are actually the complements. A complement is that which completes the predicate. Okay, all right now let's see next. Underline the verb and circle the underline verb and circle the word that completes the sense. Okay, my sister seemed upset, this is given. The donuts were delicious. Okay, so underline verb, delicious is our words which is giving the complete sense. My father works, works is verb, and in a happy hospital. So these are the words which are required to complete its sense. The students became angry yesterday. So here became angry yesterday, these are the words which requires to complete the sense of the sentence. She is innocent. So again, innocent is what? The word which requires to complete the sentence. The sun sets at 6 today. So these are the words which requires to complete its sense. Alright kids, so this is how you will get in your question paper. Okay, the type I have told how you will get it. Alright, now I want everybody to go through a very important topic, that is I have taught before verbs. Okay, so tenses is given. Okay, today we will do simple tense and it will come in the exam also. Alright, simple tense. So simple tense in case of present, past and future we will do. Alright, so first simple present tense. Beta, here simple present tense. Here you just have to understand the rule, that which rule we have to follow. There are certain rules in the tenses, okay? By learning those rules, you can just write any type of sentence, okay? So we are doing only one kind, and that is simple tense in case of present, past and future. So simple present tense rule is when the subject means the doer of the action, okay, when the subject will be singular, or we can say one, all right, one, okay, then we will use the rule subject, first subject, okay, then first form of the verb, then s or es with it, and then object. This rule we will follow, okay, in case of singular simple present, okay, this is the rule that we have to follow, all right. So singular subjects will be, singular subjects, name of a person first of all, a person, okay, then pronoun which we use for singular, okay, he, it, okay, all right, these are the singular subject, okay. How we will write the sentence? She cooks the food, okay, this is the example of simple present. How you will get to know, you can see here cooks, she is singular subject, cooks. What we have done here, we have used here first form of the verb with it as we have put, okay. So she cooks the food, this is a positive sentence. If I'll make a negative sentence, then remember one thing beta, in case of simple present, okay, helping verb will be, first of all I'm writing here helping verb, helping verb will be do or does, all right, do or does, do in case of plural, does in case of singular, okay, when the subject will be singular, helping verb does we will use, in case of subject plural subject we will use helping verb do. Now we are doing singular subject, so that I'm going to tell, in case of negative sentences, this is in case of negative sentences, negative of the same I will write, okay, she does not now cook the food, okay, she does not cook the food, all right. So this is how we will make assertive, or we can say positive and negative sentences, all right. Just have a look everyone, okay. Next I will tell you when the subject will be plural, or we can say more than one, all right. Jab hamare subject ek se zyada honge, then which rule we will follow? This rule we will follow, subject, okay, then v1 only, no s, no es, nothing, only the verb which will be given, that only you will use, then object, all right. So this is our rule in case of plural simple present, we have to use first form of the verb. In this case helping verb is, helping verb is do, okay, which will be hidden in case of positive sentence, but will be shown in case of negative or interrogative sentences, all right. Now I will write one example here, okay. So plurals are names of person, names of persons, okay, more than one, more than one, all right, they, we consider I and you, we follow the rules of plural here, all right, with I and you, we, okay, etc. These are the plural subjects, okay. So we, or I can say I or you, cook the food. So in this sentence, what we are using? We are using the first form of the verb. Alright. Now this is the case of positive sentence. If I'll write the negative one, again, do helping verb we will use in case of simple simple present, okay, plural, we will use the helping verb do. Now negative sentence we are making, so I'll write here, they do not cook the food. All right, this is how you have to make a negative sentence of simple present. Now let's do the next, simple past. Okay, simple past. All right, so in case of simple past, whether the subject is one, the subject is one or more than one, we have to follow the following rule. And what is the rule? Subject, then second form of the verb, okay, then object. So in case of simple past, we will use second form of the verb, okay, whether the subject is one, ya to subject ek hai ya ek se zyada hai, or more than one, we have to use second form of the verb. Helping verb in simple present will be, helping verb is did. Remember beta one thing, if you are showing do, does or did in the sentence as a helping verb, then after them you have to use first form of the verb. Remember this thing, okay. Now let's do the sentences here. Positive sentence of simple past will be, she, or I will take one more, he cooked. So this is second form of cook. All right, cooked the food. Okay, now negative sentence I will write here, they, I will take one more pronoun, we did not cook. Remember, as I'm using did here, okay, in case of negative sentence, so after it I have to use v1. All right, no s, no es, no second form. If we are using the did, okay, in simple past, then after it we have to use only first form of the verb, no second form, no third form. Okay, did not cook the food. All right kids, so this is very simple thing that you can do very easily. All right, simple past, second form of the verb we have to use. In case of positive, the helping verb will be hidden inside the main verb. So cooked here means what? Did plus v1. All right, whenever we will split it, okay, in case of negative sentence, then did will be separate, and then v1 we will use separately. All right, this is something I will tell you whenever you will come in senior classes. Now what you have to understand, that in case of positive you have to use second form of the verb. In case of negative sentences you have to write the helping verb. In case of simple past, helping verb is did, okay, did not, and then if you are using did, then after it you have to use first form of the verb. All right, now next we will do simple future. simple future tense. Okay, so in simple future tense, remember one thing: whenever you will go to use future tense, then in future tense we have to use helping verb will or shall. Okay, shall helping verb beta we have to use with first person pronoun, that I have shown you before. Okay, first person pronoun we have done when I have taught the topic pronouns. Okay, then I have told you first person pronouns. This is something, first person pronouns are I and we. With I and we have to use helping verb shall. Okay, except I and we, others verbs and no other noun and pronouns, we have to use helping verb will. Okay, remember this thing. Now in case of simple future, rule is subject plus will or shall. I have told where we will use will and where we will use shall. Okay, with first person pronoun shall, except I and we, with other nouns and pronouns we will use will. Okay, plus after it, remember, with will and shall we have to use first form of the verb. Okay, then object. All right, now I'll show you some example positive sentence. First of all, I'll write here, she will cook the food. Okay, now one more I just want to show. I shall cook the food. Now one negative sentence I will write here. Okay, he will not cook the food. Okay, one more negative sentence. We shall not cook the food. Okay children, so this is how you have to do. I hope you have understood this topic. Definitely 2-3 questions on the basis of simple tense will come in your exam. All right, so I want everybody to revise this video. Okay, revise it and just try to do some exercises. All right, worksheet I will upload tomorrow on the basis of grammar. You will get one worksheet. All right, just do that worksheet and prepare for your exam. All right kids, now thank you so much for watching. I hope you have understood the topic. All right, thank you so much.